Ladies and gentlemen, I am back. I'm Cincinnati Man. I'm here with another music reaction. I have a confession to make. I have never in my life ever listened to a SZA album. I know. My friend Hunter has been telling me for years how he can't believe I haven't done it. You know, so basically this is for my homie Hunter. I've never listened to a SZA album, and I saw that she won some awards and stuff. And I was like, oh, your favorite artist won awards. And he was like, are you going to listen to it? I'm like, yeah, I'm going to listen to it for the show. And then he said, no, you should listen to Control. I was like, no, I'm going to listen to what I want to listen to. So I decided to listen to Control. Instead of listening to the award-winning album that she just got awards for, I'm going to listen to the other award-winning album. So, let's get to it. Put my glasses on, not for reading, for podcasting. Okay, let's look this up. SZA, going to Spotify right now. I want to say thank you to everyone who's tuning in for the very first time. Thank you for people who check in from time to time. You know, it's all fun, and it's all very interesting. You know, so. Okay, let's check this out. Where is her first album? Spotify needs a better... Oh, here it is. Bam. There we go. Okay. There we go. Okay. Wait, is Control her first album or is it not? Because I'm seeing this thing called Z. See, this is why we have the internet, ladies and gentlemen. Maybe Z is a mixtape. I need to know because I want to get it right, even though, you know what, it doesn't matter. Let's see something. Up, Control. Okay, Control it is. And then S. Wait, what? SOS 2022. Oh, she only got two albums. That's interesting. Okay, look. We getting this going. Okay. Control. I don't even look up how many minutes it is. I typically just go into it. But here we go. 49 minutes. Okay. I thought it was going to be like an hour 25 or so. Okay. Okay, I could do this. Well, let's listen to SZA. Control. Oh, hold on a second. I got to pull up the notes. I like to timestamp it while I'm going along. I apologize. Okay, here we go. First song. Control. SZA. Supermodel. They cleaned off the bam. Hey, see, this is a professional setting, everyone. Okay. Supermodel. 1, 2, 3. Banging the homeboy. I didn't know it was. Yeah, she sounded like she'd do it again. Mm. It's probably sound really, really good live. Whoa. I didn't know it was going off like this. Well, this relationship's a mess. For real. I was not expecting the messiness in this relationship off the rip. The next song coming up is called Love Galore. It is starting in like 6 seconds. Can't hear what he's whispering, but okay. I like that the first few tracks ain't like super. It ain't super hip hop. You know, it's more definitely more like I could see like a band doing this. Which she probably does have a band. I never seen her live. This is she telling everybody business. As long as we got love, I don't know if love gonna be enough for this relationship. I ain't gonna lie, I was enjoying the song. You didn't even need Travis Scott for this song. Not at all. This song could have flowed just fine by itself. You only had a few bars on there. Thank you. Okay. Like I said, I don't know if love gonna be enough to keep you by his side. Doves in the wind. Yo. Wait, whoa, the language. Wait. How's she gonna use Jenny? Jenny was trash. You can't use that in the Forest reference. Jenny was trash. Let's calm down. Wait, let's. I'm re-listening to the lyrics wrong. What in the world? This is, I love in this beat. Kendrick. What? They could have just named the song Pussy at this point. Wow. I ain't gonna lie, this song is it's funny because he's saying all that, but you know she gonna get with some lame dude. That's the funny part. She running around like, I never, like, you whacked it. And then she's like, I can give it up, though, for something. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. That's wild. Yeah. This is I'm very surprised about this album, to be honest with you. Drew Barrymore. Okay. There's a lot of lyrics in there. Don't, not shaving legs. I'm sorry I'm not your baby mama. Karma coming for you. Goodness. A lot going on. I ain't gonna lie. Like, she has me a bit terrified. Okay. Wow, that was a really sad song about insecurities. I was not expecting that. The next song is Prom, coming up in a couple of seconds. And here we go. Off to the prom. I've never been to the prom, so I wouldn't know nothing about that. Why is it called Prom, though? Not time out. Whoa. You know, son, she's just going in this album, this song. It's not a lot of time to like really talk. You just absorbing everything. Next song coming up is The Weeknd. Right now. I didn't know what this song was till I heard the beat drop. I've heard this around. It sounds crazy in the headphones. Woo! Wait a minute. Hold up. Hold up. Hey, I'm gonna go ahead and ask: Is any of these songs gonna have somebody that she with that's not with somebody else? Tell me that. I need to understand this. I'm getting all types of confused because I don't think I've heard one song where she was actually with somebody who didn't cheat. I was leaving her. Then she's trying to get drop what? I didn't know who made this beat. Wow. Take Wednesday, Thursday. Well, that was a that was pretty intense. Wow, this beat got crazy. Next song is Go Gina. Okay. Hey, I gotta say, this is a really nice album, I have to say. Okay. Wow. Okay, the next song is Garden. It's coming up in like, what, like 12 seconds, 13 seconds? It's interesting how they start putting music at the end of the last couple of songs. What? Not the booty getting bigger. That's difficult. Messy. Oh my goodness, so sad. Don't find out who I am. Mm. Whoa, no panties on. What? What is going on? Yo. Wow. You know, sometimes you listen to artists, you be like, oh, they ain't know nothing about what they talking about. This one, this is like too personal. It's like, yo, like, hold up. You go through it up. Like it is. This is like some R&B artists you want to be like, oh, I would love to be with her. I'll be friends with her. She going to put me through it. Next song, Broken Clocks. That's a slick. All I got is these broken clocks. I ain't got no time. Wow. That is clever. She cannot stay away from the toxic. Oh, dang. I was in the groove and then the beat slowed down. Hold up. Hold up. Anything. Okay, next song is Wave Interlude. I was so in the groove, I forgot it was on the next song. Wow. Why this an interlude? Normal girl. Wavy should have been another like 2 minutes, but it's fine. You know, we good. You know, when she says she ain't normal, I mean, you know, red flag. Next song, Pretty Little Birds. Next song, Pretty Little Birds. Wow, Pretty Little Birds, you hit the window a few times. Dang. This is already, I'm gonna say this is my second favorite song on the album. I think it is. My wings don't fly spread like they used to, but I want to fly with you. They don't spread like a wow. They don't spread like they used to. Wow, man, that's pretty tight. Okay. Woo. Okay. I'm okay. I keep every time I for just about all the music reviews I've done, I've not had a problem with the music I've been listening to. As much as I perceived that I would at first. So 20 something. Is a song. Trust me, you saying you looking for love with 20 something. There's plenty of people in the 30 somethings, the 40 somethings, and the 50 somethings still ain't found nothing. You good, girl. All you got to do is be open to love and actually try to find it. Because you can't look, you can't go through life wanting love, but not but too afraid to approach it. Cause then that's how you guarantee you'll never find love in life if you never give yourself an opportunity to go towards it and wait your whole life for it to come towards you. Dang, this whatever. Ending the album on this is a gut puncher. That's my first time ever saying that about a song on this channel. Goodness. Okay, everyone, that's the end of the album. I'm That was my first time ever listening to SZA, and I really enjoyed the album. I was 100% wrong and ignorant for all the years. I was like, I don't want to listen to it. It was a nice, smooth, gut-wrenching R&B album. Like, as in, like, she, like, you could hear it in it. Like, nah, these, this some real events happening. This ain't no, oh yeah, this ain't a singer singing about events. This is a singer that's living events. And it's like, oh goodness. I got to apologize to my homie Hunter. He told me for years to listen to her, and he was right. And he told me, don't start with the one that won this these awards. Start, go, do Control. Do Control. And he was right. But I'm Cincinnati Man. I want to thank anyone for taking the time to hang out, laugh, and listen more than we spoke. Yep, on to the next one. Thank you. Take care.